Welcome to It's Supernatural with Robin Show, where we share personal experiences and scriptures on how you can walk in the supernatural. The show is mixed with off-grid living, toxic-free lifestyle, and a touch of politics. Join our host today for today's podcast, and remember, it's natural to be supernatural.
I'm going to do a very quick video because I am already at the skating rink where I'm going to practice my hockey skating, which I do every day. But today, I want to share real quick about what to do if you get lost in the courts of heaven. Because oftentimes I find that something's not going well in my life, so I say, Holy Spirit, show me, you know, you reveal hidden things. Show me what it is that I need to repent of. That Satan has, what accusation does Satan have against me in the court of heaven that I'm not getting results in this area of my life? And then sometimes the Holy Spirit will reveal to me dreams, and in the dreams I'll have instant interpretation pretty much on how to get unstuck in the courts of heaven, like what it is that's holding me up, what particular generational sin or iniquity has been passed down or covenant might have been made that will help me get further. But sometimes, like lately, I've gotten stuck in the courts of heaven. It's like I understand the protocol and everything, and I've repented of everything that the Holy Spirit put on my heart for my generation or me, and I'm still stuck. It's like, okay, Holy Spirit, I'm still not having an answer to this prayer. I don't understand what it is that I need to repent of in iniquity in my generational lines, or what I went through all the lists that I knew to go through. I went through all of the, the deliverance lists and all the lists of the things that you can be delivered of, covenants and all that stuff, and still no answer from the Holy Spirit what I need to be delivered of. And it gets really, really frustrating. So I asked the Holy Spirit, you know, I don't want to just sit here and do nothing and wait and wait and wait till I hear something, because I would be going through something for a week or something, and I still haven't heard from the Holy Spirit. What else do I need to repent of? What else is in my iniquity and in the line? Well, the Holy Spirit kind of gave me an idea what to do, and I just started doing it because I never want to sit there doing nothing. So he said, basically, go to the New Covenant and just start in any book and go through the book and see everything that is a problem, for that is a sin, or he tells you not to do, and repent of it. So I opened up to 1 Peter, and so I can show you what this means. So I opened up to 1 Peter, and let's see, I started reading, and when I got to about, let's see, where was it? Okay, when I got to 1 Peter 2, it starts off like this. Therefore, laying aside all malice, all deceit, hypocrisy, envy, and evil speaking. So I said, okay, there's a list of things I can repent of, whether I needed to repent of them personally or whether it was a generational line. So I said, Father, in Jesus' name, I just laid in my bed or sat here reading it. I just said, Father, in Jesus' name, by faith, I repent of malice, all deceit, all hypocrisy, all envy and evil speaking that I have done toward other people. And I repent of this for my generational lines all the way back to Adam, and I ask you to forgive me for this. And then it says, and as newborn babies, desire the pure milk of the word that you may grow thereby. And so I say, Father, in Jesus' name, I repent of not desiring the milk of the word enough. And I desire it more. And I repent of this. I repent of not desiring the milk of the word for my generational lines all the way back to Adam. Please forgive me for this. Then I go on and I read a little bit further. I just keep reading till something pops out at me. You go down to verse 1 Peter 2:11, and it says, Beloved, I beg you, as you sojourn and pilgrims, abstain from fleshly lusts which war against your soul, having your conduct honorable among the Gentiles. So, there's another clue. I can repent of that. So I say, Father, in Jesus' name, I repent of fleshly lusts. I repent of that, and I repent of that for my ancestors all the way back to Adam. And so, see, and then I just keep going on reading, and oh, here's another one. Therefore, submit yourself to every ordinance of man and the law's sake, and to the king, which is supreme. okay, and to the governor, and then I say, well, Father, I repent of people in leadership positions in my state, in my country, in my community, in my job, wherever. I repent of not submitting to their leadership. I repent, like if you don't like Trump, you say, I repent of bad-mouthing Trump or thinking bad things about Trump or disagreeing with Trump and not honoring him. And I honor him right now in Jesus' name. I repent of that, and I repent of all my generations before me, all the way back my family line, for not honoring the people that are in leadership above them, the people in our community and in our country, and so on. So that just shows you a pattern. You can just take any book. He said start the New Testament and just go through it and see anything that you can repent of when you run out of things to repent of because you're not having an answer to a specific prayer and you're not actually hearing from God what it is. There's something blocking the revelation of what it is that is the accusation. And so instead of getting frustrated, you can move forward by just spending time going, and this is also clearing up your gateways by going through the Bible and seeing the different sins in the New Covenant. It clears up the gateway. For example, in 1 Peter 4, if I continued, I see the whole list here of that the Gentiles walk in lewdness, lust, drunkenness, revelries, drinking parties, and abominable in doctrines. Boy, that's a mouthful. It shows I'm a hick from the stick and I'm not very good at reading. And then you say, I repent of those things for myself and for my ancestors all the way back to Adam. And so when you're not getting specific directions, when you went through all the prayers, if you go to Terry Spencer's website, if you go to Ian Clayton, Justin Abram, The Praying Medic, and all the people who teach about the courts of heaven, Ian Clayton, I think I said, especially Terry Spencer, I think, they have a lot of printouts. And if you go through any kind of deliverance ministry, I was trained in deliverance ministry, and we have sheets of paper of certain sicknesses in your body and certain attitudes and things happening in your life that sort of come from certain spirits, like a spirit of Leviathan would be certain behaviors would happen. And so that you have to deal with those, find the root of the problem, and then the spirit causing them. Well, if you've gone through all those deliverance lists, if you've gone through all the high courts lists, all like your ancestors sacrificed to Baal, or...
If you are an author or an inspiring author, we have great news for you. We publish family-safe books for only $399. You heard right. As an author of over 50 books, Robin has the experience, knowledge, and tools to get your book published and distributed worldwide as a print and digital book. Our team will take your book and create a professional ebook and print book. The following steps are what is included in our fantastic price of only $3.99 or $4.99 for picture books. Interior design and format for print and Kindle. Ebook conversion. Professional book cover for print version. Front, spine, and back. Professional book cover for Kindle version. Your ISBN number and worldwide distribution with print on demand. We do this all for you. We set up your account on Amazon and publish your book on your account. When you are ready to order copies of your book to sell or give away to friends, you simply sign into your Amazon account and order the number of books you need at a discounted price. No minimum order needed. To learn more or to start the process, go to www.robinbremer.net. That's RobinBremer.net.
One of the things in my generation, when I went back and prayed, God said that my ancestors had given their hands to Moloch and for gold and freedom from slavery. It's like, wow, that's heavy. So I repented that. These lists have things like that, breaking covenants and so forth. But when you go through all those lists and you still have a problem or the spirit still keeps attacking you, it's all legal. You have to find more things to figure out what the root is. And the devil's going to try to stop you from knowing that he even has an accusation against you and try to stop you from finding out what that root cause is, where that came in, what door was open. And so sometimes it's a fight to find out what it is, but the Holy Spirit is a revealer of secret things. And that's what I keep reminding the Holy Spirit. You're the revealer of hidden things. Would you please reveal to me what in the world is going on that I cannot have victory in this area of my life? Come on, reveal to me. And sometimes he does it in dreams. Sometimes it's like I'm waking and awakened, and all of a sudden I have this revelation. It's like, wow, awesome. Thank you, Lord. And I can just feel like the spirit of that or the heaviness of that leaving me as I repent of it. But when you run out of things and the Holy Spirit is quiet because the devil is trying to block it, then go to the Word of God. Pick your favorite Bible in preferably the New Testament. Of course, you know, you can do the Old Covenant, but you're living in the New Testament. So I'd start with the New Testament and just go through it verse by verse and see what you can find in there that you can repent of for you and your generational lines, and do it. And it will help get you closer so that when you actually go to the courts of heaven by faith, that there is less accusation against you, and prayers happen faster because you have bound up the legal loopholes that the devil has found against you and is keeping you from receiving your blessing, because God is a just God. And if the devil found accusation against you, God can't release to you what really belongs to you, because the devil is accusing you and you haven't showed up for court and say, no, I plead the blood of Jesus. I plead the blood of Jesus. I'm innocent. Apply the blood of Jesus. So I just wanted to share that with you.
Thank you for joining us for today's podcast. If it was a blessing to you, please consider financially supporting us by clicking on the Sponsor This Podcast button. Any links mentioned in this podcast will be listed below, along with any affiliate products, services, or partner websites. If you enjoyed this podcast, please share it with your social media site, and remember, it is natural to be supernatural.